Now see, in the first video we have seen the solenoid. What is solenoid? What is the magnetic field due to the solenoid? Then we have seen the different condition. At the end of the solenoid, what will be the magnetic field? At the center, what will be the magnetic field? Then if in place of air, if we insert the iron core inside the solenoid, what will happen? So that will be called as the relative permeability, and the magnetic field is given by mu naught mu r n into I. So this was the complete introduction for the solenoid. And one more thing we have seen, that for the case of solenoid, if we see the dot with the center, it indicates that the current is coming outward, and if it is cross, then we'll say that the current is inward. Okay, so now we have to see a derivation. This is also very important. This is important derivation. What is this derivation? Derive expression for magnetic field due to a current carrying wire, current carrying solenoid, not wire, solenoid, by and by Ampere circuit law. So now we have to derive the expression for magnetic field due to a current carrying solenoid by Ampere circuit law. So now what we'll consider, that this is the wooden rod. On this we are allowing the current through this wire in this particular manner. So what is happening here? Current is going inward direction, and again it will go to the outward direction. समझ में आ रहा है? करंट क्या हो रहा है? इधर से ऐसे आ रहा है, अंदर जाएगा, फिर ऊपर जाएगा, फिर से अंदर जाएगा, फिर ऊपर जाएगा. मीन्स वन स्टेज द करंट इज इन कमिंग, एंड एट द अनदर स्टेज द करंट इज आउट गोइंग. ओके, सो इफ we are considering that the current is moving inside this. Okay, the current goes in this and again moves inside. So if the current is coming in the outward direction and upward direction, and if we make a section, iska kya kiya hai, pura ka pura isko kya kiya, particularly we have made the section. So when we make the section, how will you represent that? We represent that one side will show inward, another side will show outward. So this representation is there when current is coming out and again co-current is coming in. So if we consider that the total length of the solenoid is L, the magnetic field will be generated in this particular manner. If P is the point, center point of the solenoid, where magnetic field is there. Now magnetic field is in this direction. So now we have to calculate the solenoid, magnetic field due to the solenoid carrying current by Ampere's circuit law. So here what will happen? We will consider that I is the current flowing through the wire. P is the point interrelate to the point, or P is the midpoint of the solenoid. We have to calculate the magnetic field due to the Ampere's circuit law. So what we'll do? We will take a rectangular loop. What we'll do? We will take a rectangular loop passing through the point. Why we are taking this? Because Ampere's circuit law is applied for the closed loop. Now when we consider the closed loop, P point is the center point of the wire. So what we'll do? We will consider a rectangular area A, B, C, D. This A, B, C, D is a rectangular area through which the current is flowing. Now what will happen? This A, B is along the direction of the magnetic field. This is perpendicular. Again, it is along the direction of magnetic field. Again, it is perpendicular. So what will happen? The magnetic field, this point BC and AD are perpendicular. So when we consider perpendicular, so what will happen? Theta becomes 90 degree, and because of that magnetic field will become zero. So we know by Ampere's circuit law, it is given by BDL, integration of BDL is equal to net current. By the loop. ABCD. So this is multiplied by mu naught. So BDL is equal to mu naught into net current enclosed by the loop ABCD we have to calculate. So now, before you have to understand this net current flowing through this, net current flowing through this is given by N. Why we have taken it? N is the number of turns per unit length. If suppose L is the length of the wire. So the total current through this will be given by N L capital L I. Where N is the number of turns per unit length of the wire. Capital is the total length. From here to here distance is what? L. I is the current flowing through it. So this is the current loop, or we can say the total current passing through the loop ABCD. ABCD se current kitna pass ho raha hai, that we will calculate what? NLI. So this net current is given by NLI. So this equation will become what? BdL is equal to mu, mu naught into L n L I. We will give this as what? Equation number 1. Now, we know that magnetic field due to this coil is given by the superposition principle. So what is the superposition principle? Superposition principle here for this whole wire BdL is equal to for ABCD. This ABCD can be written as first AB BdL plus AB, then BC BdL plus CB BdL plus DA BdL. So AB represent this line, BC represent this line, CB represent this line, and BA represent this line. Means ek separately idhar nikal leta hu, ye A hai, ye B hai, ye C hai aur ye D hai. So AB is inside the solenoid, DCBD kahan hai? Outside hai. But BC kahan hai? Internal hai. But BC ka per distance kitna hai? Magnetic field, and this distance is 90 degree. DA ka bhi kya hai? 90 degree. So already we know for perpendicular distance the value of BC will become 0. Similarly for this will become 0. But what about the magnetic field due to the CD outside? We know that magnetic field outside the coil is 0. So all these three components will become what? 0. So what we will be getting, what we will be having further? BdL is equal to AB. Now if we see AB, AB is the direction along the magnetic field. So theta will become what? 0. If theta becomes 0, then cos 0 is what? 1. So this equation 2 will become what? Integration of BdL ABCD is equal to BdL, B into DL is equal to AB. Now B is a constant. Now integration of DL will become what? Integration of DL means small element we have taken, so it is the, it will give the total length. So it will become B into L. So we'll give this as what? Equation number 3. So the equation 2 by substituting this will become what? Integration of BdL ABCD will become B into L. Total will become what? BL. So remaining all terms, BC this part will become 0, DL this part will become 0, and DA will become 0. So we'll have this much BL. Now what is the integration from the first equation? First equation is BdL. So from first relation what it is there? BdL is equal to mu naught nL I. So what we'll do? So first equation is mu naught n l I is equal to b l. L l will get cancelled, so b will become what? Mu naught n l. This is the derivation for I. L l will get cancelled, b is equal to mu naught n I. So this is the magnetic field due to a solenoid. So this derivation is for the solenoid.